Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video. I hope you are having a pleasant day. So in today's video, we are going to have a look at how to do this UFO shot. And all I am using is a photo and a little bit of Fusion magic. So without further ado, let's jump into Fusion and see how we set up this shot. Let's go.
Okay, so we start out here in the editing page, and this is the clip we are going to work with and make a little nicer. And we are going to start by adding in a UFO. What I have here is I have a photo. I'll just hit the F2 and I'll just write UFO. It's just a photo, and I did a polygon mask around it, so it's just a photo. And you can do a photo in Photoshop and then just import a PNG, but I just do everything inside of Resolve here or in Fusion. So I'll add in a merge node and keep shift down and drag that down into blue line, and I'll make the UFO as my foreground. So here I have the UFO, and then I'll just add in a transform node. Again, pushing shift, dragging and releasing when the line is blue. And now I'll go into the footage and figure out where the UFO are going to stop in the photo, in the picture, before I run. So let a little bit down. Okay, around here. And then I'll just go and I will size up the UFO a bit, something like that, and then I'll just drag it up and reposition like so. And then I'll go to the angle and I will change the angle, not like that, like so. And then I'll hit in the keyframe for the angle for the center and the pivot, and also for the sizing. And let's try to figure out how the UFO are going to leave our scene here. So let's say when I am around here, I am going to make it a bit larger when I'm around here. When I'm out of frame, I want the UFO to be out of a frame. So I'll make the UFO larger. I'll just zoom back in a bit, and then I'm going to remove it out of the frame. So this is what we have, a UFO flying out of the frame, more or less. So I'll go back here to this particular keyframe, and then I'll go all the way back to the beginning of our composition, and let's zoom in a bit here, and then let's move the UFO back more like so, and then I'll just size it down and make it very small. Something like that. I will move it a little further away. And now if we just play through it, you'll see that the UFO will be moving towards us. Like so. Okay. And then I might actually, and then away it goes. So I might do something more here. So let's go to the beginning. And in the beginning, I am going to take the angle and I'm going to change that a bit. Not so much, something like so. So it will also move in an angle as well over time here. Okay. And yeah, I'll be good enough, I think. And there it's aligning and flying away. So that's the beginning of our animation here, but we need something more actually to sell the effect a bit. We need to do a shadow. We'll start out by adding in a background, and I'll put that not to number two, but I'll put the background to number one. And then I'm going to put in an ellipse or a circle here. I'm just going to disconnect that. And with that selected, I am going to make a shape. And I'm going to mess around with the width and the height of the parameters here. And let's just... So I'm trying to figure out the biggest place this shadow would be. And it must be around here. So then I'll just align the shadow a bit. I'll make it a little bit bigger. Okay, and then I'll just connect those two together. And I am then going to add a merge node. Again, pushing the shift button and releasing when the blue line is highlighted. And it will connect to the other nodes. Again, I'll make this as more foreground. And now it's super black and a very visible. It's not even a shadow, it's a round hole. And we're going to adjust it a bit. And then we'll do the animation and we'll fix the look of it afterwards. So first off, we're going to put in some keyframes. In the merge node. And let's go to the beginning here. Okay, and then we are just going to size it down a bit. And then we are just going to move it so it will fit. I think it should be a... We'll just do something with the angle as well. And I will make it a little bit smaller. Something like that. Great. And let's see now. We should have an animation where it actually follows our UFO. And that looks just fine. Okay, and then yeah, that looks good. As an animation, it looks good enough, but the look of it is not good enough yet, but we'll fix that in just a little bit. So now we want to animate the last bit of our UFO shadow here. And let's just do that. Let's try to do it super quickly here. Okay, let's just move the center a little bit. And we are just, I'm just doing this super fast and hitting in some keyframes. And you can do this super better or more precise than I'm doing. I'm just trying to finish this up so we will not use too much time on this. So let's again do a little animation here, and let's go a little more, something like that. And then we are going to make sure that this should be out of the scene as well. Let's just go a little bit back here. I need to just reposition it a little bit. Okay, let's see. We'll just drag it down here. And we'll angle it a bit. And let's just go a couple frames forward, and then we'll just, again, reposition. Like so, and again, we'll just drag it out of our scene here. One sec, there we go. So that should be it. Yeah, that's good enough for jazz. Okay, so let's go back here and let's fix this shadowy thing we have here. I just want to make a little correction in the movement of the shadow, so like that instead. Yeah, that looked a little bit better. So let's keep it like that, and let's go to the shadow portion of this tutorial, and let's make this look like a shadow. Okay, so I'm just going to increase the level down and to make it a little more transparent, and then I am messing around with the border width, and I'm going to soften out the edges. And then it's just it's a matter of what you think look the best. Maybe a little tad more in the softness here. Something like that. I'll take down the level a bit as well, and then I'll border the width again, and let's have a look here. Okay, and yeah, that looks just fine. So one last thing to do to make our animation a little bit better is to go into each of the merge nodes and go here to last icon, and then add some motion blur. And the settings are pretty good already, and I'll do the same in the merge 2. Go here and add some motion blur. And I'll just add the last thing we need for our shot. So here you have the final shot with some sound effects on, and that also helps to set the effect. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share with your friends if you think it will help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.